This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Corespun, and in this tutorial, we are going to be corespinning beads. These are the beads that I have pre-threaded onto my beading thread. I'm using this super strong black nylon beading thread. There you go. And so I'm going to put my beading thread cone on the floor, but that is not the only core thread I'm going to be using for this technique. I'm also going to be using white mohair thread. I don't like using just beading thread as my core because it gets too tight and it's slippery, and I just like to have a backup thread just in case. Okay, so both of these together will be my core thread. And then the fiber I'm going to be spinning is a beautiful sparkly art bat by Feisty Fin Fibers. I'm going to add some more gold sparkle in there. And why not add some locks too for a little bit of texture. So let's get started. First, I'm going to spin a length of yarn on my wheel just to get into the groove, and then I'll bring the beads up. I'm going to tie the beginning of my yarn in a knot just with the knot of the previous yarn I just finished where I was putting feathers in it. And we will start core spinning by just wrapping our fibers over both of those threads at a 90 degree angle. So there's three different beading techniques. There's one in each masterclass: how to spin beads into a single, how to spin beads in when you're plying, and this is how to core spin beads in, obviously. Out of the three of those, I think my favorite is how to spin beads in when you're plying, because that's, I think, my favorite. I think it just makes the most sense to me to add the beads in when you're plying. So I'm going to bring all these beads up and hold them in my hand. And we're going to add the first bead now. So I'm going to bring the bead to the very front and wrap the fiber right behind it, nice and tight. And keep spinning. So it looks like we added it in a single, but it's really secure because it's corespun. And the biggest difference between corespinning beads and then adding beads in a single is that when you corespin beads, you can put them on beading thread, so you can get beads with really small holes, whereas when you're spinning your beads into a single, you need to actually put fiber through the holes. So, no, I do not want to tangle right now. So, as I was saying, if you have really big beads, those are great to put in with a single, but if you don't have really big beads, I need to come up with a way to keep this from tangling. I'm going to put it around my wrist a couple times here. Anyway, small beads, corespun, big beads, single, any beads, ply. I can tell already that this black thread is going to be a bear. Let me try. It needs to be under tension in such a way so as not to get tangled. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drape it up and over my lazy Kate rod. See up here? I have my thread coming up from the beads around my lazy Kate rod and then back down, because it needs to have some sort of tension. Let's see how that works. I think we're in business. I just want the beads not to tangle. And I don't know if I'm asking for too much. Am I asking for too much? Really? Apparently I'm demanding more than what this thread is willing to do. So, if you're in this situation, you could stop and put your beads on a different beading thread. Or, if you're like me, you will stubbornly untangle it again. See, it's twisting upon itself. That's the problem. Okay. So now what I'll do is I'm going to take this thread and put it under my foot. One more chance. I'm not feeling too confident about that either. I feel like there's a bunch of beads under my foot and it's driving me nuts. What if I wrap it around my thigh? There we go. Okay, so I'm like a human sewing machine. I've got the beads on the thread hanging down in between my legs right here, Sam. And then I have that thread coming up and over my thigh, and then it's coming out from that up and over my bobbin. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to create a tangle-free zone where my beads can just spin freely and hang, and I think we're in business. Let's put another bead on. Bring it to the top, wrap the thread behind it, and keep going. Let's bring another bead on to celebrate. Bring the bead to the front, wrap the fiber behind it, and keep spinning. It is a celebration. Yeah, this is working really well. I recommend wearing jeans when you do this, rather than a skirt. I don't feel any friction from the beads at all, but I know if I was wearing like shorts or a skirt, it would annoy me. So jeans is a good choice. I do see I'm getting a lot of over twist, so I'm going to bump up the tension. Bring another bead on. And you don't have to do just one bead. You can do 2-3 beads, you could do rows of beads, you could do like an inch of seed beads and wrap them around. Here's a little leaf bead. You could even highlight the beads, so you could take sparkle and get like a really sparkly section, and then add a bead, and then lock it in with sparkle so that all around the bead is just sparkle. Like that. One thing that I love is spinning freshwater pearls into yarn. I think it's so beautiful. And I will give you 2 cents of my opinion regarding when you're choosing beads to add into yarn. I have found that when I add cheap beads into yarn, plastic beads, some wood beads, even some bone beads, the whole yarn looks, it cheapens the entire yarn. Whereas when I add lamp work beads, glass beads, stone beads, pearl beads, it's so much nicer. I'm going to show you, I'm going to add a cluster of 3 pearls in. The same way I've added all the others. Just put them on and then Corespun the fiber right behind. And I'll show you a close-up of this. Sorry about the camera shadow, that's kind of annoying. There it is. So it makes almost a three-dimensional look. And I'm sorry it's not focusing. My camera hates it when I have both my studio lights on and I'm backlit by the sun because it's getting to evening time now. And I want to make sure I have plenty of light. The camera doesn't like to focus close up when the light is wonky like that. Okay, what's our next one? Now I have enough beads where I can hold them in my hand like this while I'm spinning, so that will save me some time. This yarn is looking very boutique-y. One cool thing about the overhead lights, is that it makes the sparkle seem a lot more sparkly. So I'll add another pearl in, lock it in by putting fiber behind. And you know what? I'm going to move the camera to give you a closer up angle of what I'm doing so you can watch my fingers manipulate the beads and the fiber. I think that'll be a lot. I think you'll enjoy more of a close-up point of view for just a second. Get So I have the beads in my hand on the string. I have my other mohair thread coming up. I'm going to bring a bead to the very top. Last one. And that is beaded. I know I was a little lazy in this tutorial and I wasn't exactly corespinning at a 90 degree angle, so forgive me. Okay. Tie the ends in a knot. Show you the finished skein on the bobbin here. And that is our finished yarn. See the beads? Super, super pretty. Love it. It's like spinning jewelry. Thank you for watching and happy spinning.